Hey guys, Dr. Rebecca here from drswarren.com, and today I'm going to be talking about seed cycling. I love talking about seed cycling because it's so much to do with what you're eating and how what you're eating can influence your sex hormones. So I've done videos on charting your cycles. I've also done videos on high estrogen symptoms and low progesterone symptoms. So both of those videos and the information in those videos are going to be very helpful and necessary if you're going to be seed cycling. So what is seed cycling? It's eating certain seeds according to your menstrual cycle. And those seeds are going to help promote balancing your estrogen and raising up progesterone. So here are some things to understand about your cycle. So there's two parts of your cycle, usually day 1 through 14-ish, and it can vary. Not everyone ovulates on day 14. And sometimes according to the month, you might not even ovulate the same month. But day 1 through 14-ish, and that's why I put the ish there, it's considered the follicular phase. It's going to be more of the estrogen phase of your cycle. Then the luteal phase is going to be your progesterone. So this is after ovulation. And I'm going to point this out, and I've talked about this in our previous videos. The follicular phase can change. It can change from month to month if you have stressful seasons, but for almost all women, a healthy cycle after ovulation will have around the same amount number of days. Between it can be range from 10 to 15. This will always be the same, but this can vary. So that's why it's really, really important to chart your cycle. So what does it look like to seed cycle? So from day 1 through 14-ish, you're going to be eating flax seeds and pumpkin seeds. You're going to be eating 2 tablespoons daily. That means 1 tablespoon of each. And then when you go to your luteal phase, day 14-ish in until your next cycle, you're going to be doing sesame seeds and sunflower seeds. So some things for you guys to know. You want to make sure that you have a good grinder. You want to grind up these seeds and have them organic, raw, and if possible, sprouting it. So an easy way to sprout is you just put it in filtered water overnight, and they're going to sprout it. They're going to be more absorbable, and you're going to really get the great nutrients that are within it. So again, 2 tablespoons daily, and so it's going to be a tablespoon of each. You can add it on top or in your smoothies. You can do acai bowls or like smoothie bowls. You can put it on your salads, shakes. You can put it on foods that you're making, bowls that you're making, just really making sure that you're incorporating this every day according to your cycle. So how do these seeds help you? So flax seeds, there's been many studies that have looked at flax seeds' effect of helping to clear out estrogen from within your body. So flax seeds have something called lignans, and they will work on taking out excess estrogen within the body, and it's also high in omega-3s. Just so you know, this pumpkin seeds is going to be high in omega-6s. So having good quality fat is going to be essential for balancing out your sex hormones. So pumpkin seeds are going to be high in omega-6, and they're going to be high in zinc. So let me go ahead and tell you guys this, just a side note, omega-6 isn't bad. There was a period of time, and there still is, especially with conventional fat and protein, that we were being exposed to a lot of omega-6. It's about a proper omega-3 to omega-6 balance. And guess what? Through these seeds, you're getting omega-3s from flax seeds. You're getting omega-6 from pumpkin seeds. Now, on the second half of your cycle, these sesame seeds are also going to be high. Oh, pumpkin seeds is zinc. Okay, it's also high in zinc. Really, really beneficial. Now, sesame seeds are going to be high in omega-6. So really, really, really good quality fat and vitamin E, which is a fat-soluble vitamin. Really great for your cycle. And then sunflower seeds are going to be high in omega-3 and a lot of really good quality fat in there. And these have lignans as well. So they're working on clearing out excess estrogen, preparing your body to produce progesterone, and to help with the production of progesterone. So guys, this is how you seed cycle. If you have any question, make sure to leave a comment. If you're already doing seed cycling, leave us a comment and let us know so that other women can be encouraged. And if you guys have any ideas or questions on future topics, make sure you let me know, because I love answering your questions on video.